Hello there, my name is Gap. Today we'll be discussing about the capabilities of Gear 2 storage. Previously, Helen discussed about web storage to help us maximize our Gear application. Today we'll be focusing on indexed database. Before we move on with our discussion, let's prepare the things we need. We will use the Tizen IDE for wearable to create our database application, and a Samsung Gear 2 device for application testing. You can use the emulator as an alternative if you do not have a Gear 2 device. Now let's review on Gear 2 storage. The Tizen IDE for wearable supports file API, index database, and web storage. The file API is useful in managing files. This is ideal for large content such as audio or video. It allows you to get file information in slice data objects. The index database, on the other hand, integrates naturally with JavaScript with its object-based data store. It provides easy lookup and querying. Finally, web storage is a storage area used to save structured data. It includes local and session storage. So let's look into the index database. This is best for those who want to store data based on objects. We see in a method in the code for calling data relevant to a key value in the storage through the get method. Also, note that there are certain values and attributes that are not supported. These are old version, new version of IDV version change event interface, and init DV version change event of IDV version change event interface. Now let's create a simple scoreboard index database. We will include an ID, name, and score. Open your Tizen IDE. Simply go to File, New, Tizen Wearable Web Projects, Template, Tizen Wearable, Wearable UI, Basic Application. Give your project a name. So let's name it Index Database. Open the index.html of your project. Let's edit the title and header to index database. Let's add 4 buttons so we can manipulate data. Now let's create a JavaScript file on the JS folder. Name it Scoreboard. Let's add 4 functions. Read data, read all data, add data, and remove data. What this does is that it calls out the version of the index database available on the Tizen wearable.
What this does is that it provides data entry, such as ID, name, and the score. Now let's open a database with the open method. The first parameter is the database name, and the second one is the database version. We can add handlers such as onError, onsuccess, and onupgrade needed. The onError and onsuccess handlers are self-explanatory, but the onupgrade needed is called when you change the database version. The code inside onUpgrade needed basically adds data when we first create our database. Let's go to the addData function. We simply added an ID 3, a person named Helen, and a score of 21. Let's go to the removeData function. This is called when we simply want to delete the person named Helen. ReadData is responsible to read a single data. We simply call the get method, requiring the ID as a parameter. We go to the readAllData function. Here we put a simple loop that loops through all the data using a cursor. Save it. Don't forget to load your JavaScript source file. Go to style.css. Let's just add this to let the button fit the screen. Let's test our application. Run the emulator manager. Or if you have a gear, simply plug it in via USB. Go to your project, then run. So let's try reading all the data. So first we have Kathleen, then Kimberly. Let's try adding. So to check if it's successful, go to read single data. And then read all data. There we go. Let's try deleting. You can go back to read all data. And there we have it.
Let's sum up the things we discussed for creating a database for Gear 2. Gear 2 supports file API, index database, and web storage. Also note that there are certain methods and attributes that are not currently supported. These are old version, new version of IDB version change event interface, and initDB version change event of IDB version change event interface. Don't forget to declare your JavaScript source. And finally, the API is your best friend. To learn how to use the other storage APIs, click on Help on your Tizen IDE. Under Tizen Wearable Web App Programming, select API References, then choose W3C HTML5 API References. We hope this tutorial helped. For inquiries, please post your questions on the official forum at developer.samsung.com. Thanks for watching.